Substitution is also a fantastic thing you can do with symbolic algebra. So say I have sims, x, y, and z, or let's just x and y for the moment. I could say, well, y is equal to 3 times x squared plus 6 times x, which is great. So if I have this, what I can do is actually I can come in here and I can say, well, I want to substitute, and I want to substitute in y. And everywhere I see an x, I want you to put in a 3. And it's like, okay, it's 46 or 45 because it's 9 plus 18. That doesn't make any sense. 27. No, I can't add. 3, it's late. 3 times 3 squared is 9 plus, that's a 27. And what else? Wait, 6 times 3 is 18. So 27 plus 18. Plus 27 plus 18. I bet you it's 45. Wait, I can't type either. I can't think and I can't type. Okay, so there we go. 18. So I can substitute in for x. Actually, if I wanted, no, just like we've talked about before, I do have to convert this to a double if I want a real number, because otherwise it's assuming it's symbolic. So see now how the 45 moved over. Compare that again to what this looks like. See here, the 45 is off to the left because it's symbolic, and over here the 45 is off to the right because it's numeric. Hi, kitty. Now, I don't actually, my goodness, kitty, have to substitute in a value, a number. I could substitute in, I could put in a z, and I could substitute in 2 times z. And that's why it's symbolic, is because I don't necessarily have to substitute in like a real number. I could substitute in a value, so that's pretty awesome. Let's see, what else can I do? Have these guys again. I'm going to have y equals 3 times x plus 3 times z if I wanted, and I could do a substitute. I could say for y, I have x and z, and I want you to substitute in 1 and 2. So you use curly braces to indicate that kind of a substitution. And again, I don't have to be substituting in values. I can substitute 3 times a new variable called k, and maybe this one is e to the k. So, you know, I can just do a direct substitution like that. So subs, that's about as exciting as it gets, but you could, kitties running everywhere, but you could definitely do something like that. And I guess if you really get interested in this, let me see, I didn't actually try this in advance, but I'll try it up here. So instead of doing 2 times z, so I could substitute in 3, which is what we did, but I think I could also go in and say, I want to substitute 1, 2, and 3. And that's pretty cool. Notice that these are still symbolic, and that's just not necessarily what you might expect to try. So I could substitute 1 for 10, and then I can get all the values that if I would plug in 1 through 10. And of course, if I care, I can double that. I'm not going to call it x, I'm going to call it values. And then that would give me those values. So that's actually pretty awesome if you want to try that with the substitution.